What are all these access attempts in my router log? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for Ask Leo. Ask Leo is brought to you in part by support from our patrons. Visit askleo.com/patron to learn more and find out how you can get benefits like ad-free access to askleo.com and exclusive content. Let's dive right into the question. I went into my router to change my password from admin and check the log. There were a lot of unrecognized access from random IP addresses to a set of fairly random ports. Are these the pages I am reading on the internet or random attempted hacks into my computer network? Honestly, you would be amazed at the amount of malicious traffic on the internet. It's truly amazing. In fact, at least one security guru, Stephen Gibson of GRC.com, coined the term internet background noise for all that traffic. What is it? Well, honestly, it's the reason you must, and I say must, have a firewall. The issue is that everything connected directly to the internet is under a slow but constant attack. There are always a constant stream of attempts to probe for vulnerabilities in the devices that are connected to the internet. These are attempts that try and look for unpatched systems, known vulnerabilities, and other basically easy ways to get in and compromise a system. Once they do, that compromised system then usually turns around and starts doing the same thing. It starts actually trying to reach out to the rest of the internet. Malware on the internet is basically what's responsible for this. There are machines out there, lots and lots and lots of machines, that are infected. They're running malicious software. For whatever reason, they haven't been updated. The malware hasn't even been noticed. Perhaps the machines are completely unattended for all we know. A lot of the times, the machines are actually quite old and doing a job that nobody thought would last this long. They're out there. They're infected, and those infected machines are reaching out to the entire internet. The entire internet? Indeed, machines like these are good at two things: persistence and speed. In other words, they can calculate fairly quickly, but they're also very patient and very persistent. So what the malware attempts to do is it very carefully, very methodically goes out and tries to probe every single IP address that's available. Every single one, all 4 billion of them. As you can imagine, that might take a while, but it does so. And eventually your IP address, my IP address, every IP address will eventually turn up. Now, it sounds like a pretty daunting task, but when you think about it, the malware is designed to share the load with all the machines that it infects. So let's say that a machine gets infected with this malware somehow, and it begins to scan the internet slowly, methodically. It looks for machines that are connected to the internet that are still vulnerable to whatever allowed it to be compromised in the first place. It finds one. It infects that one. Now there are two machines, and they can split the load. They now start scanning, and sure enough, each one of them eventually finds another machine. Now there are 4 machines, very carefully, very slowly, very methodically, scanning the entire internet. You can see that this continues as long as those machines are running and they successfully infect other machines. Eventually you end up with dozens, hundreds, thousands of machines all running this malicious software, all very carefully looking for other machines to infect. Now, I said that this is why you need to run a router. Well, that's how you solve this. I keep saying that these are machines connected directly to the internet. Putting yourself behind a firewall, which your router is, solves the problem. The problem is that the machines are trying to proactively reach you. A router prevents all incoming access. You can only reach outward from a router. In other words, your machine can reach the internet and can have a conversation with machines, other machines that are out on the internet that your machine has initiated, but no machine on the internet can initiate a conversation with your machines. And that's what this malware is all about. By being behind a router, you prevent this. And in fact, your router log showing you all of this is just your router doing its job. It's showing you that, yep, there's a lot of internet background noise. There's a lot of this stuff going on. These are all malicious software on compromised machines that's attempting to affect anything connected to the internet. Now, I have to throw out a caveat here for router logs. The fact that you were able to see one, great. Not all consumer grade routers have logs, so there may not be something for you to look at. And even if there is, it may not be turned on by default. And exactly where it lives, how you turn it on, whether it exists at all, depends dramatically on exactly which router and router model you happen to have. But it's your router that's saving you from being infected by any of this. Now, that doesn't alleviate the need to stay updated. There's plenty of other issues that staying on top of getting your machine patched, keeping your software as up to date as possible saves you from. But as you can see, this is one very blatant example of how unpatched software connected directly to the internet can actually lead to a fairly significant problem. I hope that helps explain the noise that you're seeing in your router logs and what it might mean. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/2949. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.